Hello everyone, in this video we are going to write down the isomers of C4H6. This elemental composition belongs to the general category CnH2n-2 with the n value equal to 4. So C4, 2 times 4 here, minus 2, so that you will get C4H6. And this means that the degree of unsaturation for this elemental composition will be equal to 2. So let us verify that. TOU equal to 1 plus number of carbon atoms, that is 4, minus number of hydrogen atoms by 2. So 5 minus 3 will be equal to 2. And therefore, we can have an alkyne carbon-carbon triple bond or an alkadiene 2 carbon-carbon double bonds, or we can also have a ring plus double bond, or we can have 2 rings. All these possibilities we need to explore, and let us do this one by one. Number 1, we can write butane-1-ion HC triple bond C, CH2, CH3, and the same structure in bond line notation is, this is butane-1-ion, and then we can also write butane-2-ion H3C, C triple bond C, we just shifted the triple bond position, CH3, and the same in bond line notation will be like this. This is butane-2-ion. And then number 3, we can write butane-1,2-diene. So in condensed form it will be like this. This is butane-1,2-diene. The same in bond line notation will be like this. And by the way, we keep the A here because it is an alkadiene. For alkadiene, we keep the A. We don't call it butane-1,2-diene. Even though 2 vowels are coming successively, we still keep that. Okay, this is an exception for alkadienes, just for better phonetics. And then number 4, we can also write butane-1,3-diene. And the same in bond line notation. So this is butane-1,3-diene. And then number 5, let us write down the fused bicyclic ring. That is something many of us forget, so let us write that down first. So the same thing in bond line notation will be like this. This is a fused bicyclic compound, and the IUPAC name for this will be bicyclo, and then in square bracket 1.1.0, because on the bridgeheads we don't have anything else, so that's why 0. And then parent chain contains 4 carbons in total and therefore butane. So it is like 1, 2, 3, 4. So the value of x equal to 1, y is also equal to 1. So you can take this carbon as x and then this carbon as y, and then the value of z equal to 0. No carbon atoms are there on the bridge heads are basically directly connected. So it's a fused bicyclic compound, and therefore the value of z or z is equal to 0, and that's why bicyclo in square bracket 1.1.0, close the square bracket, and then total 4 carbon atoms are there, that's why butane. And then let's go to the next one. And then number 6, we can also write a 3-membered ring with the double bond, like cyclopropene and then a methyl group attached to it. So the numbering starts from here, 1, 2, 3. And the same thing in bond line notation will be like this. So this is 3 methyl cyclopropene. And we can just bring down the methyl group to the 1 position, that will be another structure. The same thing in bond line notation will be like this. So this is 1 methyl cyclopropane. And then number 8, we can also write a structure like this. The same in bond line notation will be like this. This is methylidene cyclopropane. In the earlier literature, we used to call this molecule as methylene cyclopropane, but this has been changed recently. Is because whenever you have a CH2 with a double bond that is attached to something, we refer that as methylidene. On the contrary, if there is a CH2 that is like attached to a single bond with something else, then we can call it methylene. For example, let us say you have a molecule like this. 1, 2, 3. What do you call this one? We call this one as trimethylene diamine, right? So because we basically have CH2, CH2, CH2 and then NS2 on both ends. So that's the time we refer this as methylene. And if it is directly attached to a double bond, that time to differentiate that it is connected to a double bond, we call it methylidene. This is the preferred name. And then number 9, we can also write cyclobutene. Yep. A 4-membered ring. That is something we forgot. So this is number 9. Cyclobutene. So yeah, in total 9 isomers are possible for C4H6, and these are the 9 isomers that are possible for C4H6. I have seen some videos where either people forget the bicyclic ring, this one, bicyclo 110 butane, and then they count it as 8 isomers. That's not correct. I have also seen videos where they mention the bicyclic compound, but they forget the buta 1,2 diene, and so missing the total count once again and making it as 8. That is not correct. Total 9 isomers are possible for this elemental composition. That is the correct answer. Thank you for watching this video, and if you do like this video, consider subscribing it to Chem Media.